I've listened to many of the speakers, and there's a lot of good ideas and a lot of good conversation happening around this particular issue, but what's required really is action, and action from the government. And I'll just give you a couple of examples of where the government is seriously breaking down and where the weight is being left in regards to this particular crisis. A couple of years ago, the Meath Food Bank was itself homeless, and I offered them the use of my constituency office. And one of their main activists there, Aisling Lowe, since that time has fed countless children and parents out of the constituency offices in Trim. Many of them desperately seeking food on a daily basis. And the level of child poverty right across the country is absolutely harrowing. And I can think of Brother Kevin Crowley of the Capuchin Day Centre in Dublin. Again, you know, we are regularly seeing images of mothers and babies and buggies queuing on the roadside for nappies, baby foods, etc. And it would actually break your heart. As a pro-life activist myself, I find the neglect of these young women and their children by your government shocking, Minister. It has been left to charities to actually pick up the weight with regards to this issue. And we are a nation of a big heart, and you know, we like to help, and many people get involved in charities, etc. But it should not be left up to the work of the charity sector to deal with this crisis on a daily basis. It should not be left up to the reliance of the generosity of the Irish people to pick up this weight whatsoever. And, you know, I'm listening as well with regards to the lack of departmental working together. I know of a homeless student who was refused the SUSE grant last year. Homeless and still refused the SUSE grant. Another student who was a primary carer for the father and refused the grant. And these many people and these types of situations are slipping through the cracks. And what I can't understand is why can't the Department of Health, the HSE, or the Department of Children, or TUSLA, work together, for example, with the Department of Further Education on these issues? If it was the other way around, Minister, if it was a student that was receiving the PUP grant, for example, there's no doubt in my mind that the department would work seamlessly together with the Department of Further Education to make sure that that student was refused that SUSE grant in that situation. The Minister is obviously talking about ending direct provision, but last year my office received a phone call from a man living in direct provision who was in hunger strike, and I asked that man why was he in hunger strike and what did he want, and he said to me he wanted money to be able to buy baby food for his daughter. How can a government that dresses itself up in progressive political clothes see a situation that is so cruel to so many people in Irish society? You know, there's another situation with regards to direct provision. There are so many people who have been granted asylum and international protection after a long and tedious process, but they still find themselves stuck in these centres because the state is not offering the financial means from where they can actually build a life for their families from scratch. And, you know, I've asked this question of yourself through written questions, and you told me that there's 1,185 people in this state in that situation. And when I asked the government, what are the government doing about it? The government said that they're talking to St. Vincent de Paul and the Father Peter McVerry Trust to sort it out. Again, another example of a government outsourcing responsibilities to other organisations to do the work that the government should be doing. And it is an absolutely disgrace. And what I would ask, you know, where is the comprehensive 360-degree plan to get rid of poverty in Irish society? Minister, I don't know, does one exist? Because it everywhere I look for that type of comprehensive focus on ridding this country of child poverty, it is nowhere to be seen. And what we have is a government dressing itself up in the language that sounds good, but not delivering on the action, and actually offloading the responsibility to community groups and charities to do the heavy lifting, and that needs to stop.